We're in a village right now. We're in India, and it's a really poor village. The people live in a thatch. Huts and houses. This is like a communist village, and you know, Hindus and all types of different people here. So we've been seeing lots of miracles, lots of healings, lots of salvations. We just saw like just a ton of the village members just receive the Lord, make a decision for Christ. And so the power of God is just reaching to the margins of the earth, the margins of society. We're releasing the love of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, the reality of the gospel message.
Oh, bless you. She got ba 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 ba.
Carrying this heavy kiss, yeah, I've gotta lose this weight. Somewhere the light is strong, there I'm gonna lay it down. I'll rise when my ship comes in. I'll stand up and you lead me. Gonna climb on board, leave these burdens behind. So don't cry when my ship comes in.
I'm just gonna put a grin on her face.
I can't bring it anyways.
You feel that? You feel his power? You feel his presence?
Yeah.
Jesus is going to turn his frown upside down. There it is. Oh, there it is. Yeah, look at that. Look at this. Can she see anything right now?
Yes.
We're just praying for her eye, and she says she can see out of her eye. We just pray. She's covering her good eye right now, and she's starting to see out of the one that she couldn't see before. Hallelujah. She's seeing. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. That eye is beautiful.
And what I understand is she wasn't able to sit and stand up by herself before we prayed. Is that right?
One year.
She's in a lot of pain. She was kind of like sad.
Now can she show us how she can sit down and stand up? See how what God did for her?
Yeah. So maybe
she can get up
by herself.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Pray for your head. Thank you, Lord. Right now, just whack that head up with the blood of Jesus. We just put a blood of Jesus dot right there, and we just release. Thank you for having us to your beautiful village. We want to pray a special blessing on your village. See, Jesus is the true God.
Yes, Christ the
because He is the God of love. When Jesus comes to a village, He blesses it. And when we choose Jesus to be our only God, then all of His blessings come. Only Jesus can give you eternal life. This is the greatest decision you could ever make. When one generation chooses Jesus, then many generations are blessed. It's so good. This gift fills you with joy. Fills you with sweetness. Takes away all of your sorrow. So all of you right now who want to receive Jesus, I want you to stand up to your feet. Very quickly, stand up. When you receive Jesus, You can receive Jesus and no other. Everybody say it. Say Jesus and no other.
Jesus
and no other. Jesus, come into my life. Come into my home. I receive your life. Jesus makes you new.
Salt water.
We just command the bitter waters to turn sweet right now in Jesus' name. We just put the tree to the water. Sing to the well. Oh, we sing. Bitter waters turn sweet. Bitter waters turn sweet.
There's something better to drink from! Yes. Something better to drink from!
It's a sign that Jesus is the true well.
Oh, Maria, devudu ikkada adbhutam chesadu.
And anyone who's thirsty can come and drink of Jesus. Hey guys, I just wanted to stop for a minute here and give a real big thank you to all of our partners. You guys know who you are out there, and we really sincerely appreciate you guys sending us all around the world, and you guys are just a major part of the ministry here. You guys are making the stuff happen, just like you saw in the video here, and you know, with our children's home in India, the mass crusades, and beyond just the masses, you know, these individual people whose lives the Lord is changing through all of us. And you know, as we all work together, we're definitely making more of an impact than if we were just to go out individually and try to do our own little thing. So we just want to say thanks so much, and also just want to encourage you. You know, we just appreciate your partnership, not because you have to help God out, but because you know, we're all expecting breakthrough in our own lives and our own ministries as we sow into the agenda that God has in the earth. And so we just want you guys to encourage you to expect a harvest. Expect that God has something in this for you as well. As you partner, you're sowing into other people's breakthrough, but the Lord knows that you have a breakthrough yourself that's right around the corner here, and you're moving in thanks to the work of the cross and your seed as a response to that glorious offering of His Son that He's given you. So I just want you to say, you know, don't feel selfish for expecting a breakthrough, and we just want to pray favor for you, that all of you guys out there that need a breakthrough, you know, all of us are in, to some degree, have been in some type of poverty, some type of brokenness that the Lord is pulling us out of, some type of sickness, some type of addiction that the Lord's pulled us all out of, and you know, the Lord delights to lift us out of the slums and out of the garbage heaps and seat us with the princes of the people. So we just pray favor on you guys as you sow. God bless you, and thanks again for your support.